Hello everybody. Today in this session we'll discuss International Monetary Fund. Now International Monetary Fund today also for this session we'll go through the help of International Monetary Fund official website. Now actually how I have accessed it, first I have gone through the Google, then in Google I have given IMF. So there was a link imf.org/external then slash. So from this website we'll do a learning today. Today's class are based on the International Monetary Fund, and again we'll discuss, you know, central banking meaning and definition and functions of the central banking in India. So these are the two things we'll cover. Number one is we'll know about the International Monetary Fund, and secondly we'll talk about the central banking meaning, definition and functions of the central banking. Now coming to the International Monetary Fund again, like as I have mentioned that we are accessing the official website of the International Monetary Fund. And we are very much thankful to International Monetary Fund also, and they have also one well designed, well informative websites, and our session will be based on this. Now from this session we'll learn about International Monetary Fund and its different areas of activity. Now first we'll talk about the International Monetary Fund at a glance. At a glance means the summary of the International Monetary Fund. Now if we talk about the International Monetary Fund, like these information are being updated on 22nd March 2019. So here, like we'll talk about the International Monetary Fund at a glance. At a glance means the summary, in brief summary of the International Monetary Fund. Now the International Monetary Fund or IMF, International Monetary Fund, you know, popularly also known as IMF, promotes international financial stability and monetary cooperation. It also facilitates international trade, promotes employment and sustainable economic growth, and helps to reduce global poverty. The IMF is governed by and accountable to its 189 member countries. Now see, like first we are going through what kind of tasks IMF performs, and IMF promotes international financial stability and monetary cooperation. Then IMF also facilitate international trade, promotes employment and sustainable economic growth, then helps to reduce the global poverty. Okay, and it is basically administered by and accountable to its 189 member countries. Okay, now the founding and mission related information. Now the IMF was conceived in July 1944 at the United Nations Bretton Woods Conference in New Hampshire, United States. The 44 countries in attendance sought to build a framework for international economic cooperation and avoid repeating the competitive currency devaluation that contributed to the Great Depression of the 1930s. The IMF primarily mission is to ensure the stability of the international monetary system. The system of exchange rates and international payments that enables countries and their citizen to transact with each other. Now, see, like another thing, like supervision, surveillance, like this is another vital, you know, task IMF perform is to serve doing the surveillance, or we can say in order to maintain stability and prevent crisis in the international monetary system, the IMF monitors members' countries' policies as well as national, regional, and global economic and financial developments through the format system known as surveillance. Okay. Now then, financial assistance. IMF also provides loans to the member countries that are experiencing actual and potential balance of payment problems is a core responsibility of the IMF. Now, balance of payment is a term related to the international trade. International trade specifically related to the export-imports matters. Okay, and IMF provides financial assistance or financial loans to the member countries with regards to the balance of payment. Just we are going to the summary. Going through the summary, so if you want to go through the detail, you can go through. Then another is capacity building. Like the IMF provides technical assistance and training to help member countries to build better economic institutions and strengthen related human capacities. Okay, like World Bank performs the task of capacity development. Now, capacity development related to the skill improvement, knowledge sharing, increasing technical expertise. Then special drawing rights, SRD. SRD is known as special drawing rights. Now, see, the IMF issues international reserve asset known as special drawing rights or SDR that can supplement the official reserve of the member countries. Okay. Now, resources. Member quotas are the primary source of IMF financial resources. Member quotas are the primary sources of IMF financial resources. A member's quota broadly reflects its size and position in the world economy. See, he joined late. Prasanjit Baddha, you came late. The IMF regularly conducts general reviews of quotas. Now, main thing here we need to learn that IMF also perform a task of resource sharing, and this is basically financial resources. And for that, a member have quotas, and that broadly reflects its size and position in the world economy. Then governance and organization. The IMF is accountable to its member country governments. At the top of the of its organization structure is the Board of Governors, consisting of one governor and one alternative governor from each member country. Usually the top officials from the entire from the central bank or finance ministry. The Board of Governors meets once in a year at the IMF World Bank annual meetings. Now, these are the more these are also most important facts about the World Bank. Now, total countries having membership with International Monetary Fund is 189 countries are member of the International Monetary Fund. Then International Monetary Fund headquarters are in Washington DC, United States of America. Where is the International Monetary Fund headquarters. It is in Washington, D.C., United States of America. Then executive board, 24 directors, each representing a single country or group of countries. Then staff, having staff approximately 2,700 from 150 countries. Then total quotas, then borrowed resource envelopes, okay, capacity development spendings. Now this is another vital area. I have highlighted it. Primary aims. Primary aims means the objectives. Objectives of the International Monetary Fund. This is one vital area you need to know regarding the objectives or aims of the International Monetary Fund. Now, International Monetary Funds promotes international monetary cooperation. What the International Monetary Fund do? International Monetary Fund promotes and supports international monetary cooperation. Then, International Monetary Fund also facilitates the expansion and balanced growth of international trade. International Monetary Fund facilitate the expansion and balanced growth of international trade. Like among the member countries, trade is happening smoothly or trade is expanding or not, balanced growth are happening or not. These are also main objectives of the International Monetary Fund. Then promote exchange stability. This is also another important function of the important aim or objective of the International Monetary Fund, and this is promote exchange stability. Then assist in establishment of a multilateral system of payment. Assist in establishment of multilateral system of payments, like working on the multilateral system of payments for the all member countries. Then make resources available to member countries experiencing balance of payment difficulties. Now see, balance of payment, just a little bit few minutes ago I said that balance of payment is related to the international trade, or we can say balance of payment are very much related to the international trade, and more specifically it is related to the export and import, okay, among the member countries of the International Monetary Fund. Now if any countries facing problem regarding the balance of payments, then International Monetary Fund provides resources, economic resources to help that member countries so that balance of payment difficulties can be overcome. So these are the some important primary aim and objectives of the International Monetary Fund. So just we'll give again quick revision. The primary aims of the International Monetary Fund is to promote international monetary cooperation. Then next, to facilitate the expansion and balanced growth of international trade. Then promoting exchange stability among member countries. Then assisting the establishment of multilateral system of payment. And finally, make resource available to members experiencing balance of payment difficulties. Okay, so these are the some very important objectives of the International Monetary Fund. Now we'll move to another area, thing I would like to highlight here. Like in the previous class, I have mentioned that if you are having an aspiration to develop a career in organization like World Bank, International Monetary Fund, then you can go through the job opportunities or career option. So here just we'll go through the job opportunities. See here, job opportunities. Okay, so if I click, then you know this page is coming where their vacancies are there. So apply now. If I apply now, click, then how to apply? How to apply is written, then selection process. Okay, so just if you go through this, I will not go through the detail of this, but this is a, you know, direction or hints I have given. If anyone having the aspirations to make career in this renowned, world renowned organizations like IMF, World Bank, okay, or in Reserve Bank of India, okay, then you can go through this and you know, you can know and you can prepare yourself in that way. Now, apart from this, we'll go through the research, like International Monetary Fund conducts a lot of research. Okay, and they have also publications also, like their flagship publications are like World Economic Outlook, then Global Financial Stability, then Fiscal Monitor, External Sector Related. Okay. Prime publications of the IMF are like staff discussion notes, then working papers, then IMF research perspective, economic review. These are the some research oriented work International Monetary Fund conducts, and these are the list of the, you know, member countries. If I click I, we may get the name of, you know, India. I like, see here, India. Okay, so this is International Monetary Fund, and here India, our country's membership or representative representation. Okay, so these are all, you know, 189 countries details are given alphabetically. Then capacity building. Capacity building is a very important, you know, area where, you know, Reserve Bank of India, World Bank, then International Monetary Fund, like this organization works on continuous basis. Now, you know, here through this process, you know, International Monetary Fund tries to increase the, you know, skill, the knowledge, technical expertise, knowledge of the member countries, sometimes the government official of the member countries also. Then data, like IMF finance, then, you know, like this data collection they are having. Then publications. In, see, what earlier we have discussed, these are the research-related publication. Research-related publication categorized into two parts, flagship publication and other publication. Now here, this is basically the actual publication part. In the publication, they have IMF e-library, then IMF bookstore, then IMF annual report, the finance and development, World Economic Outlook, Global Financial Stability Report, Fiscal Monitor, External Sector Report, then regional economic reports, policy papers. Like this, you can see lot of publications they conduct. Then this is basically the IMF social media engagement. You see, you know, IMF as a world renowned monetary body, they have, you know, lots of, you know, social media engagement, starting with the Twitter, IMF Twitter, IMF Facebook, IMF LinkedIn, IMF Instagram, then IMF YouTube, then IMF podcast. Okay, so like this, you know, they have lot of social media engagement, because this is, you know, age of you know, internet or you can say information technology. information technology is spreading like anything, and in these regards, you know, virtual platforms are doing extremely very well, and expanding very rapidly also. So this is basically the, you know, all about International Monetary Fund. So from this, what we have known about the, you know, IMF. About IMF, IMF is a, you know, is known as International Monetary Fund, and it promotes international financial stability and monetary cooperation. And IMF also facilitates international trade. Then IMF promotes employment and sustainable economic growth. And IMF also tries to reduce the global poverty. Then IMF is having 189 members from the world. So after this, you know, we have highlighted, we have gone through the primary objectives, aim of the IMF. Then few more detail we have also gone through. So here, you know, a question may come like, what do you understand about IMF? Then write short note on IMF. Then what are the objectives of International Monetary Funds? Then what are the functions of the International Monetary Fund? Okay, so next we'll move to central banking. Central banking meaning and definition. Then we'll go through the function. Now, before starting the central banking system, I would like to inform you that already we have covered the functions of the central banking. Now, I'll tell you how we have covered it. First, we'll go through the central banking meaning and definition. Then when we'll start the function of the central banking, then I'll tell you how we have covered it. Just one minute. Now, see, this is we are starting central banking meaning and definition. Central banking basically is a banking system which provides interbank relation to provide service to the different bankers. Or we can say the structure provides for interbank relation is built upon what is called the central banking system. Now, though the economic and market condition of particular countries cause variations in operations in the central bank, The one principal duty of all the central bank is to maintain the stability of its monetary unit in the best interest of the general community. Now see, simply regarding the central banking is a system through which our Reserve Bank of India basically functions as a central bank in India, and there is a system works like in the previous class I have said that like we have accounts in bank like savings account, current account, fixed deposit, and we receive the banking service. Now we may have accounts in State Bank of India, Punjab National Bank, then private bank like HDFC, ICICI Bank, Kotak, Yes Bank. Okay, but for all these banks, there should be a bank, and that is basically the central bank. Okay, now in different countries, the nature and dimension of the central banking system are different based on the resources available there. Like in developed countries, their system is much more developed. People are educated. Their GDP is very high. So they have different kind of central banking system. Different country means slightly different. But countries like India or other developing countries, they have different kind of central banking system. Now, more or less all the central bank of any nation performs quite similar kind of tasks. Now, this is a if we go through the sentence again here, the structure provides means bank central banking structure provides for interbank relation is built upon what is called central banking system, like bank relation with a bank. So if we go through the function of central bank, you will understand that how it is worked as a interbank relation. Okay, now before starting the function, I would like to inform you that already we have covered the functions of the Reserve Bank of India. So functions of the Reserve Bank of India are as same to the functions of the Central Bank of India. Okay, because Central Bank in India is taxes performed by Reserve Bank of India. Now again, just we'll go through the highlights of the functions. Central Bank as a bank of issue or monopoly of note issue. Now see, Central Bank as bank of issuing currency, or Central Bank is the issuer of the currency, or Central Bank issues note. These all function we have discussed in the session of Reserve Bank of India. There we have discussed this function, so just we'll highlight it. This is a revision type of session for central banking. Now second function is the central bank as a government's banker, agent and advisor, or government's bank. Now central bank works as a government bank or government's bankers. Like as a human being, we need a bank. So government also need a bank. And central bank works for the government as a banker, then agent and advisor. Time to time, central bank advise governments on different monetary matters. Then it is also known as government's bank. Then next is the central bank as a custodian of cash reserve of commercial bank और बैंकर्स बैंक। नाउ सी लाइक सेंट्रल बैंक वर्क्स एज ए कस्टोडियन ऑफ द कैश रिजर्व ऑफ कमर्शियल बैंक और बैंकर्स बैंक। लाइक ऑल बैंक्स, ऑल कमर्शियल बैंक्स कस्टोडियन इज टू इज विद द सेंट्रल बैंक एंड सेंट्रल बैंक हैव द कैश रिजर्व ऑफ ऑल बैंक्स। देन नेक्स्ट इज सेंट्रल बैंक एज द कस्टोडियन ऑफ नेशंस रिजर्व ऑफ इंटरनेशनल करेंसी। इंटरनेशनल करेंसी से फॉर एग्जाम्पल डॉलर, पाउंड, यूरो, दीज आर इंटरनेशनल करेंसी। देर आर लॉट ऑफ इंटरनेशनल करेंसीज दे आर। सो सेंट्रल बैंक इज ऑल्सो द कस्टोडियन कस्टोडियन ऑफ नेशंस आवर कंट्रीज इंटरनेशनल फॉरेन एक्सचेंज रिजर्व। ओके, और वी कैन सिंपली से दैट सेंट्रल बैंक होल्ड्स द सेंट्रल बैंक होल्ड्स द होल्ड होल्ड द ऑल रिजर्व ऑफ इंटरनेशनल करेंसी। देन सेंट्रल बैंक एज द बैंक ऑफ रीडिस्काउंट एंड लेंडर्स ऑफ लास्ट रिसोर्ट। सेंट्रल बैंक वर्क्स एज ए बैंक ऑफ रीडिस्काउंट एंड द लेंडर ऑफ लास्ट रिसोर्ट ऑल्सो। द नेक्स्ट इज द सेंट्रल बैंक वर्क्स एज ए बैंक ऑफ सेंट्रल क्लियरेंस सेटलमेंट एंड ट्रांसफर। ओके, नाउ हियर सेंट्रल बैंक ऑल्सो वर्क्स एज ए क्लियरिंग हाउस। क्लियरिंग हाउस फॉर चेक एंड यू नो डू सेटलमेंट एंड ट्रांसफर फंड्स फ्रॉम वन बैंक टू अनदर बैंक। देन वर्किंग ऑफ क्लियरिंग हाउस, सेंट्रल बैंक ऑल्सो वर्क एज ए क्लियरिंग हाउस ऑफ चेक। लाइक ऑल बैंक इशूज चेक। ओके, सो कस्टमर ऑल्सो इशूज चेक। सो the central bank worked as a clearing house of the all kind of checks. Then central bank as controller of credit, this is you know one of the vital function central bank performs, working as a controller of credit. Like the main principal method of credit control used by the central banks are like bank rate, open market operations, cash reserve ratio, then rationing of credit, like these things. So these are basically some important function of the central bank. Now, today in this session, what we have discussed? We have discussed like first we have discussed about the International Monetary Fund. In International Monetary Fund, we have gathered information about International Monetary Fund. Then we have discussed the objectives or aim of the International Monetary Fund. Then in general, we have discussed the functions of the International Monetary Fund. Okay. Then secondly, we have started central banking. Central banking meaning definition, then functions of the central bank. Now see, central banking basically it's a system, and or we can say structure of interbank relation. Okay, where you know. Our Reserve Bank of India works as a central bank, and earlier in one session in detail we have discussed the different functions of the Reserve Bank of India, and just today we have highlighted the functions again so that you know you can recall later on very easily. And for today's session up to this. And thank you everybody for participation. Next time we will meet with another topic.